Welcome friends, today we are going to discuss the new feature of UFD which is called as image based identification or insight identification. Okay. So basically what is the principle behind this insight based identification? The idea is HP team has tried to implement the human like identification which we follow while identifying any object around us. Object can be anything visible to us, it can be laptop from which we are seeing this video, it can be any friend of yours, anything around you. So the idea is how we identify those objects. Just take a practical example, any person is staying in your neighborhood. You don't know the name of that person, you don't know any family background of that person, what that person is doing. But suppose you are meeting that person in the marketplace, you are able to recognize that this is the what same person which is in which is living in my neighborhood. So how come that's possible? Because we are able to relate that person using that image identification. The idea is we may be able to relate the things based on the hair color, hairstyle, or the color of the person, maybe it's his eyes, or how the skin color is, or the smile of the person is, or the attire, the dress up, or the look is like of that person. So the idea is everything is based on the appearances. So on the same principle, HP team has designed a thing what is called as inside or image based identification. So in this, the principle is what UFD uses only the appearances of the objects. Nothing, the inside properties of that object is not used for the identification of that object. So let me show you the demo. So this is our UFD. So the application which we will be working is our flash calculator. This is the same example which UFT team has given. So what I am trying to do is, I am firstly going to record any action on my calculators. Okay, I am in the recording mode of 1 plus anything, 2 is equal to anything. So I am stopping that. So let's see. So all the coding has come up. So it has come up in the form of coordinates. Everything getting identified as coordinates. Because why? Because UFT was not able to identify that object. Let me comment that. So now what I'll use inside feature now for recording. So go to default. First was the default. So I'm selecting inside recording. What I'll do now? So I'm doing the same steps again, but the difference will be how UFT will identify the object. So see how the recording has now been done by UFD. Everything was taken as a parent, browser was taken a parent, and child was taken as that inside object. So when I hover that, these are basically the images. When I clicked on 1 plus 2, the result was displayed. So this is what, when I hover on these images, the bigger one is shown on that. When I double click on that, it will directly take me to the OR, object repository shown. See, these objects are added to my OR. Okay, it's basically the images of that object. So we can even change the settings of the display of the image. In case I just want to change the width or height for identification which my UFD is using, I can do that. In case I want to change the what the pixel vision should be, I can make it center, I can just customize that. Okay, so I can save that. Fine. So the idea is like, it will use only the image based identification. It won't use the assistive or mandatory properties or smart identification, but it can use ordinal identifier for the identification, or it can use the visual relation if we want to give for unique identification. These features can be used. Okay. So in case I just want to add my objects using inside method, I have to go to add inside object, double click on that. Okay, it will give me the two options. One is automatic way, other one is manual way of adding. So I'll give you the example of automatic. And automatic, when I'm go on automatic mode, suppose I'm clicking on 5, the object will be automatically identified by UFD. It will give me the option to expand that. In case I just want to increase the identification area, I can use that again. Customization can be applied. I want to zoom in, zoom out, everything facility is given. Okay. So it was automatically identified. Now this object is added to my OR. In case I just want to highlight it, I'll click on that. See, it will point to my 5 object which I've added now to my OR. In case I have to work with using the manual one, I can do that also. So I have to select this inside again, manual one. So idea is it will convert to draw the here structure, and I have to particularly identify that object which I just want to identify. That is zoom in facility I want to select to. So it will select that object. Now I have to expand it. So to increase the area for identification, I can use that. So I'm using that. So I'm adding that object. So in case I just want to highlight to check the verify that this object is added, I can do that. So one more important feature of this inside based is the similarity description properties. Okay. So here I can change the value of, in case I just want to add, this is what similarity feature is there. Similarity is basically the criteria used for my UFT to for the identification for the similarity factor. Suppose my there is some variation in the image color or what theme. So it is a basically a tolerance which my UFT will take into consideration while it is matching my test objects with the runtime object. So by default it is 80%. We can set it any value. We can set it like constant or parameterize that. We can do that. Or when suppose I'm setting at 60 now, it will behave at 60% comparison factor will be considered while comparing the my test object and my runtime object. Okay, and in case I just don't want these images to be displayed in my code, I can do the settings. I have to go to tools in options, do your testing. Then we have inside. I'll uncheck this option. Lot of options are there. You can try it out for the inside, like save the click coordinates or display mouse operations. In case we don't want these images to be displayed in my coding, I have to this uncheck this option. Okay, I'm applying that. See, now it has directly taken the object name from my code. So let me summarize the feature of image based identification or insight based identification. Just to summarize all the things, what we did insight based identification, this was the physical way of identification, a similar track UFT also do that. So what is the important information regarding this is, like, this is the best scenario. It's used in the concept when my UFT is not able to recognize my EUT. So everything is getting recognized at win object, winner or win object, it's better to go for this image-based identification so that my UFT can identify my AUT objects. Or when you're working with on remote machines or non-window platform, so it's better to go for inside identification rather than going for like coordinate-based identification. Another thing is that mandatory and assisted properties and smart identification are not used for while identification or by UFT by identifying the objects using this inside mode of identification. These features are not taken into consideration, but we take into consideration audio and visual relation identifier taken into consideration for unique identification objects. UFT can use these features, and there is two ways to apply that. We can use it as manual or we can use it automatic. Another way is we can use image or its names that have to display in an item. We did that using tools and options. That means we are going to inside and do testing and inside. Okay, and similarity feature, that's like how similar my object can be. Well, when UFT is working with the test object and runtime object, so similarity picture is considered to taken into consideration. By default, it is 80%. Another most important thing is, like, we can use descriptive programming while working with my inside based identification method. So similarly, like we used to give the property name pair, we can use that. But we can use that index colon is equal to any value 2, 3, or we can give that image source of that where my image is saved. So DP is also possible. So that is all from our end. This is what we have in our this tutorial regarding image based identification. So this is the best feature which we found. So we started with this. So any doubts, any confusion, anything you want to learn from our team, ufthelp.com, just please feel free to contact us. Any feedback or want to publish any article on testing, just contact us. Okay, we will be there to help you out. Thanks a lot. Okay.